So about 2 years ago, I did a little showing of this knife just to answer some questions and to give people an idea of what it was like to use. I wanted to do a follow-up to that now that some people have asked some questions and I've been using it for a while now, so I've got a good amount of experience with the knife. It is no longer available through Cold Steel. It does look like they have finally discontinued it. It was part of a specialty series of these high-end Sanmai 3 folders that they did. This was the last one to finally get discontinued, but it does look like it's no longer available. But if you find one through somebody else, through a third party or through some forums or something, here is what I can tell you. First off, I had commented originally that this thing was a real solid locker and that it was relatively easy to deploy and hard to close. First off, it is still relatively easy to open, very quick to deploy. It was originally really hard to close. You really couldn't do it one-handed. Once you have used it a while, that completely changes. It's actually quite easy to open and close both one-handed. You just have to get the hang of it. The problem I've had, this is not the original knife that you saw in the first video. I actually ended up sending it back because I paid a hell of a lot of money for it and I didn't like what had happened. And what had happened was, when you open this, originally, I commented on how tight it locked. And that when you went to unlock it, you heard a click. And you heard a click in the original video that it went pop right there. After you use it a while, that is no longer true. And what happened on that knife, and what has also happened on this knife, is it actually, and I'll see if I can get close enough here for you to see it, if you put back pressure on this blade, that liner lock will move. And there you can kind of see it probably wiggling a little bit. It's not in any danger of collapsing that I can tell, but it definitely is not rock solid, especially compared to other knives that I've used, which is kind of disappointing. The fact that it happened to this knife as well, I just sort of accepted it as a course of just the way this particular design must wear. It's unfortunate, but it's not been, worth getting rid of. I do still carry this. I mentioned in the first video, I plan to make this an everyday carry knife for me. It has been. I use the hell out of it. I've sharpened it probably 3 or 4 times over the past 2 years. It holds an edge very well. It has remained very solid otherwise, besides the liner lock issue. I still don't like liner locks. I've never really been a fan of them. But generally speaking, still a very nice knife, was still worth the money, and if you can find one, especially used at a decent price, it's very likely worth the investment. Especially if you like big knives, it is a big knife. We've commented on this before. It is a light knife for the size, I think, but it's still very, very solid. Otherwise, that's, I think, everything I can tell you about it after 2 years. It still looks good. It still looks relatively new. It's not scratched up too bad. The blade has a little bit, I don't know if you can see a little bit right along the leading edge here, just some very light surface scratching. That all actually could be polished out with a nice buffing compound. They aren't deep at all. Otherwise, very nice knife, and hopefully Cold Steel will come out with a new series of knives at some point that are a little similar.